Well, guys, thanks very much. A little bit later on today on WCW Saturday Night, you're going to see two rough and tumble guys from Anchorage, Alaska. You know them as High Voltage. Let me introduce them formally. This is Rage. This is Chaos. And Chaos, I've heard it said that you and your partner really have become tag team specialists.
I like that word, Lee Marshall. Specialist. Absolutely. World Championship Wrestling talks about dismantling their tag teams. You have one Steiner brother here, one there. You have Booker T with a strap around his waist. What about High Voltage? I'll tell you about High Voltage. High Voltage is two young, determined, hungry men who anybody with any knowledge has been following the sport have been in Japan kicking tail for the last 6 months. And it's time to come home and get a chance to take what is ours. And that is a chance at the heavyweight belts.
Let me ask you about this experience in Japan. Can you take that knowledge, Rage, and bring it to where the big boys play?
Knowledge. Knowledge is power, and power is knowledge. Absolutely. We've proved ourselves in Japan, and now it's time to prove ourselves here in WCW. We're the two youngest, hottest commodities in WCW today. We are the tag team for the next millennium. So don't touch that dial. You just might get a shock, the aftershock.
Fans, he is right. Do not dare go away. We've got more great action coming up for you on WCW Saturday Night. Whoa.
Hi, Gannett Attention Hotline fans. We have people talking about leaving the squared circle for greener pastures. And now there's a new face in town who appears ready to unleash some fury on the opposition. But just who is that opposition? I've got these hot stories and so much more during my in-depth WCW Hotline Report, available right on up until midnight tonight. The number to call, 1-900-909-9900. That's 1-900-909-9900, $1.69 a minute. Kids, get your parents' permission before calling. Oh, by the way, Internet fans, coming up on Thursday night, April 2nd, tune in to WCWWrestling.com for Malice at the Palace from Tampa, Florida, another live Internet-exclusive wrestling event that you won't see anywhere else. Check it out at WCWWrestling.com. Get all the details and be part of the action.
Tag team action next up on Saturday night, Mike. High Voltage, Rage, and Chaos to take on the men making their way to the ring right now, Scott and Steve Armstrong.
Well, there seems to be a theme to tonight's program, Rage and Chaos, as we see the Armstrongs make their ring entrance. They're considered among the elite of the wrestlers produced by the Power Plant Training Facility, among the initial wave of graduates. And this team has really come into their own recently after gaining some very valuable in-ring experience over in Japan. They adapted very well to the physical style of the Orient. And this young duo from Anchorage, Alaska, well on their way to big things in WCW. They've added many of the physical aspects of Japanese wrestling into their U.S. game plan.
Every time I hear that little shocking noise, oh, like the living legend Larry Zbysko says, that sounds like a meniscus tearing in the knee. Once I heard that, I can't listen to that again without just cringing. Rage and Chaos, High Voltage. Next up on Saturday night, and this is not going to be a cakewalk. They're in there against the experienced tag team, the Brothers Armstrong, Scott and Steve.
I can tell you the WCW matchmakers were really impressed with High Voltage's recent showing in a Nitro battle against the NWO's Vicious and Delicious, Scott Norton and Buff Bagwell. It was a case of a strong showing in a very competitive matchup for High Voltage, and as a result, Rage and Chaos will be given another stiff test this Monday on Nitro against a veteran team from Minnesota in Wayne Bloom and Mike Enos.
Wow, what a contest. What an opportunity for a High Voltage against Enos and Bloom. But right now, they better focus on Scott and Steve Armstrong. Scott and Steve Armstrong have not exactly had a few number of wins either. They are a potent tag team and capable of beating any tag team in WCW on any given night.
Well, in the tail of the tape, the two younger brothers of Brad Armstrong have a measurable experience edge over High Voltage, obviously giving away substantial weight and power to Rage and Chaos.
Chaos under the ropes, leapfrog by Scott. Hip toss by Scott Armstrong on Chaos of High Voltage, and Scott Armstrong not following up. They don't teach you that in the power plant. They teach you that right right into the gut by Chaos, and a left forearm in the side of the head of Scott Armstrong.
Scott, did you hear anything in the locker room about the big appearance by Roddy Piper this Monday on Nitro?
Oh.
We know he's going to be at Nitro,
yeah,
returning to issue a challenge. Did you get any more scoops in the locker room?
Other than everyone in the locker room area is talking about the return of the Rowdy Scott, Roddy Piper, Monday night on Nitro. Who's he going to challenge? We don't know. Cover! Did not even get a count, I don't think, on Rage, the bigger of the high voltage team. Now, press gorilla slam by Rage on Scott Armstrong. Steve comes in, catches a boot in the midsection.
Well,
everyone talking about Roddy Piper.
That's the one constant. We know that when Piper shows up, big things happen. A major impact player, always a major effect on WCW and the NWO, and we expect huge developments this Monday at Nitro.
Top rope double clothesline by Chaos of High Voltage takes the Armstrong brothers right to the canvas. Rowdy Roddy Piper has never once made an appearance in World Championship Wrestling that wasn't a complete upheaval of everything there is in the New World Order. We have seen the New World Order cower at the feet of Rowdy Roddy Piper. I wonder if he's got something in store for the NWO Monday night on Nitro.
Well, when Hot Rod arrives on the scene, you know it's going to be memorable. So be a part of it on TNT Live this Monday, and also at Freedom Hall in Louisville, Kentucky.
Oh, yeah. Louisville, Kentucky, what a great wrestling town that is. A lot of history in Louisville, and history will no doubt be made Monday night on Nitro when Roddy Piper returns to WCW. Scott Armstrong and Chaos at the ringside area. Steve Armstrong and Chaos, I assume, are the legal men in there. Steve Armstrong, a little something for Rage at ringside. Look at Scott Armstrong as Chaos draped across the top. Mark Curtis distracted, as he should be, by Rage, who will not get outside. Rage hurting his own partner.
Double team tactics by the Armstrong brothers have High Voltage really slow to get started in this matchup.
Why was Steve Armstrong doing jumping jacks in the ring? Shoots Chaos in. Chaos, sunset flip on Steve Armstrong, but Curtis distracted by Scott Armstrong. One, two, three, come on. He had him for a six or seven count.
Again, that's the experience edge that the Armstrongs have. Great timing.
Double teaming Chaos, missing the double clothesline. Oh, all three men head to head, shoulder to shoulder in the center of the ring.
Well, very important now for Chaos to make his way to the corner, get the fresh man Rage into the battle.
The good thing here is there is no fresh man on the Armstrongs. Both men were rocked by the double shoulder. Now Rage taking over. Drop kicks for Scott and Steve Armstrong. Rage sets up Scott Armstrong. Powers him up.
Oh!
And over. Oh, boy. A release belly-to-belly suplex by Rage. Tag made to Chaos. Chaos going up top. With the guillotine leg drop into the side slam by Rage, the cover. Then he got the two count before Scott made the save.
Well, excellent teamwork by High Voltage, including that move, the Bulldog delivered by Rage.
Now Chaos, quick tags by High Voltage. Chaos takes Steve Armstrong up top. High crossbody off the shoulders by Rage, cover. And the three count, and High Voltage scores the Duke on Saturday night.
Well, in addition to power and strength, we see that Rage and Chaos can certainly perform some high-risk moves as well.
That is worth taking another look at as Rage and Chaos of High Voltage score an impressive victory over the Armstrong brothers on Saturday night. We'll do it in our Starburst Slow-Mo Replay of the Week, brought to you by Starburst Fruit Juice. Need a boost? Give it some juice.
There's the double arm lariat delivered by Chaos. The release suplex by Rage. The leg drop from Chaos, all leading to the springboard cross body block and another win for High Voltage.